Hello. Today, I would like to talk about a feature that I honestly didn't know existed. I have no clue for how long it's been there, and you can use it in the whole suite. Affinity Designer, Publisher, and Photo. Okay, so I have here my canvas ready, and I'm gonna come here to the primitive shapes. And if you toggle this, you're gonna find different shapes in here. Well, let's just choose this one, the cog tool. And I'm going to press and shift, put it there in my canvas. If you are already familiarized with Affinity Designer, you know that these little dots you see here, the orange dots, you see them there, they allow you to modify your initial shape, which is already very cool. It's amazing, no? It's super nice. See, you can do all sorts of changes to it, creating new shapes. I was always happy with this, and I was always storing my assets, if I wanted to reuse them, etc., etc., etc. Until 3 days ago, I was just messing with different shapes, trying new things, and I spotted this little cog in here, and I clicked on it. And oh, what is this? So we have this panel which is filled out with lots of different presets. If you see here in this Affinity Designer old icon, they didn't change it anyways. So these ones are the ones that Serif included for this particular shape. So if I now click in any of them, let's just say this one, bang, it changes it. That's pretty cool already. But there's more. Now, if I click on it and come here, I press on this top right menu, you're gonna see here that you can manage presets or create presets. Obviously, this is ghosted or grayed out because I didn't make any change to this one, so there's no possibility. But let's just try pressing on A, which will reveal all these little dots that allow for changes. Let's just do something like whatever, just to try new things. Now I come back here to the panel and again to the menu. And I can now create my own preset. So I'm going to create it. I'm gonna name it Yahoo. Like that. And I create it. Bang! It's included in this category. Now you can see that the ones that Serif created have this little icon with the Affinity Designer logo. But the one I created not only has the name in here displaying, but also has like a little user icon in there. That means I created it myself. It's my own creation. Now, obviously, if I now unclick this one, what I'm going to see in here is not the related shapes to this one here, but all of those who are related to this one selected in here. But if I now go like this and select that one, I'm gonna get the category for this one. Now, there's more to it. Let's just check here in the Manage Presets, and you can see we have all of our presets here. Now, I created this category myself when I was messing around with it. We're going to create a new category just so you see what's going on here. Let's call it Test. We created it, now it's added down here. It has no presets in it. Now, if I want to include a preset, what I have to do is either import it. This will take you to import something from your OS. But I can also just, let's say, just take this one and I can pass it here. You can see now it's in my test category, but not anymore in my category. Now, what if I want to store this one in this category? Well, I close here first, having it selected. I come here, right click. Export preset, put it somewhere there, and then you can see the extension Affinity Tool Presets. Just leave it there, and then you can import it from the Manage Presets area. Okay, so that's the way you would do it. You can see here import presets, you can see here import presets. So just clicking, importing, and done. Now, there's also this interesting combo here. And if we toggle it, you see it says no filter. Now we're going to try with, for example, the first option, which is rectangle. It's gonna bring here all the shapes related to the rectangle in this combo here without having to leave the manager. Let's just try again with a pie. It's gonna show us our pie. I've been here, as you can see, doing my things. And so forth. I mean, this is quite clear to understand what's going on. So you can just move through the whole series without having to see the whole thing. You know, it's gonna be easier. Another interesting thing about this panel. So let's just come here and say, well, I have the star selected, and let's just pick this kind of like coronavirus little thing. So yeah, I come here and I modify it, and I'm just doing some cool daisy or whatever, and I say like, okay, yeah, well, I can either go back like it was, or I can just come here and check in there. I click on it and it just brings it back to what it was. That makes total sense if you think that even if I click on any of the other, it's going to just reflect on my shape. Now, one very important thing, especially for those of you who are not yet very familiarized with the primitive shapes in Affinity Designer, because I get this question a lot. So you see I have my shape selected and I don't get these little red modifier little dots. So the thing is that you're not gonna get them like that. You have to either press while selecting in your keyboard like so, or let's go back to the move tool, which is V on your keyboard. Come in here and selecting your node tool, you're not gonna get them right away. You have to double click on your shape. Okay, now one thing I was saying at the very beginning is that I find this very useful to have here my little repository of primitive shapes. Of course, I could use my assets panel to, you know, create a library of assets and stuff, but this is kind of like a different concept. You have all the possibilities for each and every primitive shape to be stored and modified and used and reused time and again in just one place. And yeah, I mean, for me, it's a discovery. I hope it is for you too. Now be sure to visit my website. You have it there, where you're gonna find more tutorials for free, freebies, information, and the usual shit. So I see you there. Kisses.